Now we can calculate the void content from the following formula. Capital V, V equals to VV divided by VC. Here, VV are the certain volume of voids, which has been assumed as a certain volume. And VV is the volume fraction of voids. It means capital VV is the volume fraction of the voids, and small VV is a certain volume, right? And this has been ratio with the overall volume of the composite VC. Now the total volume of the composite with the consideration of void will be as follows: VC equals to VF plus VM plus VV. Now, by the definition of experimental density, rho CE means experimental density of composite. The actual volume of the composite is VC equals to WC by rho CE. Now, by the definition of theoretical density, rho CT of the composite, the theoretical volume of the composite will be VF plus VM equals to WC by rho CT. Now, substituting the preceding expressions which we had discussed above, the final equation will be WC by rho CE equals to WC by rho CT plus VV. And from the preceding expressions, the volume of void can be calculated as VV equals to WC by rho CE, and within bracket, the difference of the two, rho CT minus rho CE divided by rho CT. Once again, I am reminding you, rho CT is the theoretical density of the composite and rho CE is the experimental density of the composite. Now the volume fraction of the void from the above equations, capital VV equal to small VV divided by VC. And again, the difference of the two, rho CT minus rho CE divided by rho CE. Now from the above discussions, we are required to solve an example which is based on graphite epoxy. If you remember, the earlier example was based on glass fiber epoxy, and now this is graphite epoxy, and the shape of the specimen is cuboid, which has the voids with the dimensions, with certain dimensions, and has the mass m and within suffix c. After putting it in a mixture of sulfuric acid and hydrogen peroxide, this is a new thing which is used to avoid the voids from the specimens. The remaining graphite fibers have a mass MF, right? And from the independent test, or you can say a series of tests, the density of graphite and epoxy are rho F and rho M respectively. And you have to find out the volume fraction of the voids in terms of small a, b, c, MF, MC, rho F and rho M. Here, A, B and C are the voids dimensions, and M within suffix C is the mass. Now in the present slide, we can discuss the solution to the problem. The total volume of the composite VC is the sum of total of the volume of fiber VF, matrix VM and the void VV, and that constitute VC equals to VF plus VM plus VV. Now from the definition of density, we may have the ratio of small vf equals to capital MF upon rho f, and the ratio for matrix, volume matrix, equals to mc minus mf divided by rho m. As the specimen shape is a cuboid, so the volume of the composite vc equals to abc. Now, by equating the above two equations, we may have the volume of the cuboid, it means the product of all three dimensions ABC equals to MF over rho F plus MC minus MF divided by rho M and plus the volume for the voids. Now, furthermore, the volume fraction for the voids is equal to capital VV ratio of small VV divided by ABC equals to, we may put the values from above equations, 1 minus 1 divided by ABC, and within bracket MF over rho F plus MC minus MF divided by rho M. Hence, in this way, we may able to find out the volume fraction for the voids within the given quantities like ABC, MF, MC, and rho F, rho M. Now, the preceding problem can also be solved by using the equation of rule of mixture. From that, the theoretical density of the composite can be defined as rho Ct equals to rho F V dash F plus rho M and within bracket 1 minus V dash F. Here, V dash F is, or I mean to say capital V dash F. And please be emphasis on this. V dash F is the theoretical fiber volume fraction. The theoretical fiber volume fraction V dash F can also be calculated as volume of fibers to the volume of fibers plus volume of matrix. Now V dash F equals to MF upon rho F divided by MF upon rho F plus MC minus MF divided by rho M. These all have been converted into the terms with density. Finally, we may have the volume for the voids equals to 1 minus 1 over ABC and MF plus rho by F plus MC minus MF divided by rho M. All are the given quantities like ABC, M, rho for the different constituents like fiber and the matrix. So in this way, we may have the alternate solution for the same problem and we may calculate the volume for the voids. Now, the same problem can be discussed with experimental determination. Like the fiber volume fractions of the constituents of a composite are found generally by the burn or acid digestion test. This we had already discussed in our previous slides. These tests involve taking a sample of composite and weighing it. Then the density of the specimen is found by the liquid displacement method, in which the sample is weighed in the air and then in water. The same we had already discussed in the bullet points. Now, the density of the composite can be calculated with the help of formula rho c equals to wc divided by wc minus wi into rho w. Now, wi is the weight of composite when immersed in water. Now, in the current slide, we can calculate the density for the composite, rho c, when the specimen float into the water and a sinker has to be attached with it. Overall density of the composite can be found as rho c equals to wc divided by wc plus ws minus ww, and the whole has been multiplied by the rho w. Here wc, obviously the weight of composite that we had already discussed, ws weight of sinker when immersed in water, ww weight of sinker and specimen combinedly when immersed in water. Now the sample is then dissolved in an acid solution or burned. Glass based composites are burned and carbon based composites are digested in solution. This already we had discussed in detail in our previous slides. Henceforth, we can conclude this session in which we had discussed about the micromechanical analysis of a lamina for the calculation of their different constituents, like we had discussed about the burn test, like we had discussed about the digestion test to be performed with the help of different acids. And I also said that we can perform the same experimental analysis in our labs also. Now onwards, we'll discuss about the micromechanical analysis of a lamina for different elastic moduli. In elastic moduli, we will have to discuss about the four elastic constants for a unidirectional lamina, and those are, if you remember, longitudinal Young's modulus, that was abbreviated as capital E1, transverse Young's modulus, capital E2, major Poisson's ratio, nu 1 2, in plane shear modulus G12.